Oh, I do love it here. The air is so soft and it smells so good.
I really miss this place.
I do too. It feels like home.
Well, in that case.
What? Ah, what are you doing?
What's it look like I'm doing? Welcome to Hawaii, Mrs. Moore.
Hey, I said I'd grab those. You should be resting.
Oh, no, I slept for hours on the plane.
Yeah, which proves you're exhausted, Jason.
You know, I would have been exhausted if I didn't sleep.
I think what neither of us is trying to say is that you're still recovering from brain surgery.
Sam, I'm fine.
You always say that you're fine, Jason. You can be in a car accident and shot, bleeding all over the place, and you say that you're fine.
Well, I'm fine. I'm fine.
I mean,
right
I remember
now.
Going to Pentonville, and you had bruises all over yourself, and you said you were fine then,
Sam,
too.
Surgery worked. I'm okay.
Okay. I'm sorry. Maybe it's just being here again. When you were having your surgery, I was going through all the pictures from Hawaii, and I was trying not to think about what would happen if you had died or woke up and didn't know who I was.
Well, that didn't happen. And I am right here.
I know. But still, I can't stop wondering. I mean, if you had woken up a different person, could you have found a way to love me again? What if you had woken up and wanted to be a doctor? If you somehow miraculously got all of Jason Quartermain's memories and were this clean-cut, preppy kid, you wouldn't want a girlfriend, much less a wife like me.
Would you rather be with a doctor?
Hey, where'd that come from?
Oh, come on, you know, I think about it sometimes. If you could have any talent or skill, would really the ability to pull the trigger shut your emotions down in somebody's life, would that be the choice?
I know you wouldn't choose that.
Well, I chose to pick up the gun for the first time.
Who gave it to you?
Sonny did.
Okay. You wanted to help him. So you learned how to shoot a gun.
I can't blame Sonny for what I chose. And you know what? You're just way too easy on me.
Oh, really? What if I'm just the woman who loves you? Who feels how good and gentle you are? You know, I never let myself count on anyone until I met you.
I count on you too.
Are you nervous about being married?
No.
No?
No, are you?
No, I don't know, maybe a little. I mean, people say that it changes who you are, and I like us exactly the way we are, so I was thinking that maybe we should just set a few ground rules.
Wait, rules?
Hear me out. I'm just saying that if one of us does something to make the other crazy, we should be able to talk about it.
Well, you don't make me crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, not that much.
Stop it. I'm serious. It goes back to what we were talking about before. We should be able to ask for what we want.
Okay. What do you want?
Deep, meaningful conversations so I can know your innermost thoughts and motivations.
Okay, besides that, really, what do you want?
I have everything I want.
Except a lay?
You
asked for one at the airport?
No, I mentioned that they smelled good.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry the stand was closed. I'm going to get you one tomorrow.
No, you're not. I don't want you to go anywhere. We're going to be here for a while. I want you to surprise me. with Alay. And actually, I want to give you some time to figure out what it means. You can go through the guidebook. Do you know what giving Alay means?
Actually, I do.
Oh, yeah? Let's hear it.
It means love. From the one who gives the lay to the one who receives it.
Wow. Good. It's good.
Well, you inspire me.
Hold that thought. I got something.
Yeah, once or twice.
I knew we'd make it back here. I always wanted to, and I was not coming without you.
I love you so much. And I don't know why life worked out this way, and why we had a second chance. Maybe there is no reason for it, but it is a gift. We should go.
Okay.
I promised you we'd watch the sunrise.